Mrs. Huff, I am back again with another haul. Aren't you sick of these already? I think this is the second to last one. I think I have like six of them in all. I don't know, I don't remember. There are so many of them. But the thing is that I ended up with some money that I could spend on whatever I wanted to. And so I decided to do a whole bunch of shopping, and then I won't be doing any shopping for a while, like until I actually need things. So yeah, I did go a little nutso, but it's fine, I have no problem with that. So there are two parts to this particular video. One of them is a sizable order from one brand, and the other is one single product. So I did an Oz sale haul, which I probably have not uploaded yet, but I will have by the time I upload this one. I'm going to try and upload them in order. And there was one item that hadn't actually come with the rest, and I kind of forgot that it hadn't come with the rest. So it arrived the other day. I had another one of those days where I came home for three parcels. Or actually, I picked up three parcels the same day that we picked up our new car. So I was on sale, and they often have high-end brands for reduced prices, and the prices are still stupid, like, still stupidly expensive. And in this case, it wasn't as stupidly as expensive, but still considerably more, and you'll see why in a minute. And I'm one of those people, I would love to be able to try every single brand of nail polish if I could. Obviously, some brands have already been discontinued, so that makes it not possible. But some brands are so expensive that unless you can get them on sale or somebody gifts them to you, you probably wouldn't pay for them, because they're so expensive. And it's, you know, wanting to try them out is partly to see whether any of the price is justified, and often it's not justified. The obvious one would be the Louboutin nail polishes, which are stupidly expensive, and they're also terrible. I don't know one person who has used, like, you know, a lot of their nail polishes who could say that they're good nail polishes. Their formula is actually not very good at all. But because it's Louboutin, everybody wants it. And the packaging is cool. Like, I'd like the packaging just to display, but I'm not about to pay that much money for that nail polish. It's so ludicrously expensive, it's not funny. So the nail polish in question is, in my opinion, ludicrously priced when it's full price. In Australia, this nail polish is around $40 a bottle. And we're not talking about a big bottle either. We're talking about a fairly small bottle. So a lot of the prices on, I don't know whether they were actually different size bottles, but a lot of the prices for this brand on Ozsale were like $25 a bottle, and I was not prepared to pay $25 for a bottle of this nail polish. I can buy two nail polishes from indie brands for that kind of money. In some cases, I can buy more than two nail polishes for $25. So, yeah. But then I saw this one bottle. I don't know why its price was different, but it was $14.99. And I'm like, okay, for that price, I will buy a bottle of this bloody polish and see if it's any good. So, I haven't actually tried it out yet. And I thought I would share that joyful experience with you. So, I'm not actually going to see it yet because I haven't, but I will after I've finished this video. I'm actually going to swatch and insert. So you'll know my opinion on this nail polish before I do. Well, I'll know it, but it'll be in this video before I get to it. You know what I mean? So, Lancôme nail polish. This is a 6ml bottle of nail polish. It costs $14. $15. That's the same price in Australia as a bottle of Revlon nail polish. Like a big ass bottle of Revlon nail polish. I could buy 4 of BYS nail polishes for almost that price. So this is the nail polish. The bottle is cute AF. It's got the little tiny Lancôme rose emblem thing right there. If it would bloody focus, there we go. So it's kind of a pinky red. It's called Very In Love, I believe. 165N. So this teeny tiny 6ml bottle, $15, but it's Lancôme, and I actually quite like Lancôme as a brand, but most of their prices are stupid, and you know, the original box is like cute and everything, so yeah, I'm going to insert the swatch that I do of that particular nail polish, and insert it in here. Okay, so the second part of this video, which is already at 6 minutes, 6.5 minutes, is an order from an Aussie indie brand that had some trouble last year. There was a massive amount of controversy in the naily world. There were some very, very pissed off people, some people who lost some money, some people who were very nasty about the situation, and unfortunately the owners of this company got caught in a very difficult situation where there was legal issues preventing them from explaining the situation. And basically they were forced into a position of closing their business for a period of time. Now, I'm on their on their email list, so I noticed a few weeks back I got an email from them about some of their polishes that were polishes that had been basically just like sitting around or whatever that hadn't been sold previously, and they were doing a sale on it, and I was kind of like, I don't know. And then I got another email a couple of weeks later after I had come into this little bit of money, and I thought, I liked the nail polish when they were flying high. I wasn't stung in the whole blow-up thing that happened. I don't know the full story. I'm not going to make any assumptions or any judgments on that. That is something that they've had to deal with. And they do have messages up on their website that if you'd made an order last year when all of this trouble actually happened, that you should contact them as soon as possible, because, you know, the goodwill of the customers is the thing that you can't buy, you have to earn. And I think they really wanted to fix up the situation. What little I understand about the situation was they had given control of some certain aspects of the business to somebody else, and that turned out to be a bad idea. And it came back and it bit them in the ass, basically. So the brand I'm talking about is pretty serious. I have quite a few of their polishers already in my collection. And before the whole kerfuffle thing, there was a whole bunch of polishers I really wanted to buy, and I didn't get the opportunity to buy them because everything kind of went kaput, and I was a bit, you know, toey about putting any money into it. And then they did this sale, and the price was more than reasonable. I can't actually remember how much I paid. I don't have the receipt sitting in front of me. But it was quite a reasonable price. And I think it was less than $50 in the end that I spent. They were only shipping to Australian addresses, though. So this was not like an international thing. It was only aimed at Australians, probably because of the difficulties with shipping internationally unless you've got special clearance, or you use a courier, basically. So I decided that I was going to buy some of the polishes that I had really wanted before, ones that I liked the look of, and because it was around, I think around the $50 mark, and I've got 12 polishes here, I kind of felt like if I got bitten in the ass and I didn't get the order within 3 months because I PayPal'd it, I could get my money back. I got the order within a week of sending the order in. So yeah, I'm like, okay, fine, no problem. And I noticed that some of these are in the old packaging and some of them were in the newer packaging. They had a change in their packaging, in the, like the color, it's like blue versus purple type thing. So there's some of that. I don't know what the difference is. I don't know which one's which. I think the purple one is the new one, because it's the one that's got... It might not be. Anyway, I have 12 polishes here. They will show up in a swatch video when I do the swatch sticks for these. I have to get some more swatch sticks first before I can do that, though. Yeah, so, where shall we start? Let's start with this one. So, the first one I'm going to show you. I love the boxes, and I usually keep them, but I probably will not keep them this time. Once I've swatched them, I probably will ditch the boxes. So, this is a Purple Monkey Dishwasher. I love the name. This has actually been in their catalogue for quite a while, and I've wanted it for quite a while, and... Yeah. So it's a very dark purple, lots of shimmer and stuff going on there. It's got sort of a fuchsia glitter in the purple. It looks like a purple base. So that's Purple Monkey Dishwasher. Then we have this one next. I think three or four of these, I think, are from a particular collection, if I'm not mistaken. They're a collection I really wanted at one stage and never got hold of because it was right before everything kind of fell apart with them. So this one is 88 miles per hour. It is very pretty. I don't know how to describe it. It's kind of like a browny beige. Looks like it's got linear... In the camera, it looks like it's got linear hollow. Let me look at it in person. It's definitely got holographic in it. It's not actually linear. It's more that that's just where it's sitting in the bottle. Yeah, so it's got holographic in it, and it's got other... Oh, hang on. It has linear and normal holographic by the look of it, and scattered holographic by the look of it. Really interesting. So that's 88 miles per hour. That would be the speed limit in Australia. It's about 100 kilometres an hour. I think that's what that refers to. Then we have Dimension X, which is kind of a gold with silver glitter. Personally, I really like this kind of rectangular, like squarish, not too huge bottle shape, because they sit together really nicely. Round bottle. I really like square bottles. I think that's a little bit of my mother's OCD, because round bottles don't sit together properly. Get too many gaps. Weird. Alright, the next one is a... It almost looks like a multi or a duochrome metallic. It's called Nitopia. And it's a green with a gold shimmer through it. I don't know how well you're going to be able to see it. But it's a metallic. A darkish green metallic, and there's just this gold swell through it. Super pretty. I know that Omnia would like that colour. And she would also like this next one, especially now that she's got glitter base coats. Peel off base coat. This is called Grim Demise, and it is green glitter. It's almost a teal, but it's green, and it's packed full of glitter. It's glittertastic. It's very pretty. I actually have two more greens on the outside. Is it Omnia or Omnia? The next one we have is called Emma Louise. I have a friend whose daughter's called Emma. I think she might even be Emma Louise. Weird. Okay. This is very much me in a bottle. It's purple and it's got tealy green glitters and purple glitters and... Very nice. Then we have my darling Clementine. Leave me a comment down below if you can guess what colour my darling Clementine is. It's Clementine coloured, clearly. Clementine's a type of orange, in case you didn't know. Of course it had to be orange. So this is actually orange with what looks to be a... What's got a duochrome shimmer in it? Because I swear I see pink and sort of like a greeny teal other than this super bright orange. I have no descriptions of these. And on the website, there are no colour descriptions. There was just the polishes in... And like older, like the original pictures. So yeah, no colour descriptions on these ones. But that is so freaking good. I mean, I don't think you guys got to see, but it's got this most amazing looking shimmer on it. Now the next five, I think at least three of these were from a collection. Two of them, I'm not sure. So the first one is Dorado. And Dorado is another... orange. Let's shake. So this is an orange with scattered holographic and also orange glitters in it, and it is beautiful. You might not be able to see the holographic. As I said in my last video, one of my last videos, very gloomy. Here, it's winter, It's pissing down outside, so kind of makes it hard to show hollow, but it's definitely in there. It is absolutely stunning, and I don't think I have another orange holographic. Then we have Serpens, which is another holographic. This one, I think it's holographic. At the very least, it's got green and gold shimmers in it. Pretty sure it's got a holographic in it too. But again, kind of hard to see. So this is Serpens, which is kind of like almost a forest green. So beautiful. Now these last three, I'm pretty sure, I think those last two were part of this collection as well, but it's been a while, I can't remember, but I'm almost certain these three were in a collection. So we have, I think it's Pisces, P-Y-X-I-S, I think it's pronounced Pisces. 100% certain about that, I'm sorry, but it is a lime green with a gold shift holographic glitter, and it is beautiful. It's kind of like one of those ugly pretties, because it's that like weird shade of green. Stunning. Stunning. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. Then we have Lyra or Lyra. It depends on where you're from. L-Y-R-A. Depends on how you pronounce your Y's when they're in a word. So Lyra or Lyra is completely up to you. Sorry, the reason I was being all smart ass about that is because someone I know in one of her videos, she comes from Canada. She calls them decals, whereas we would call them a decal. And somebody commented that the way that she said it is wrong. It's the way that Christine from Simply Now Logical says it as well. It's a geographical thing. It's like, how you say it, how you were taught to say it, is how you say it. Just because other people in the world don't say it the same way. So I would call this Lyra. But if you want to call it Lyra, that's fine. It's pink with holographic and I think silver shimmer in it too. But it's a bright, kind of bright rosy pink. Oh, so pretty. Oh, look at that holographic. I don't know if you can see that. I can see it in the monitor. It doesn't mean it shows up on the camera, like on the video I found. Sad face. And lastly, but by no means leastly, we have Karina. And this is a purple holographic. It's just freaking stunning. This is the one that I really, really, really wanted when this collection first came out. Because it is beautiful and purple and holographic and beautiful. Yeah. And, you know, my collection could always handle, you know, three or four more purple polishes. I have over 160 purple polishes, and somebody said, don't you think that's too many? And I was like, but I don't have every shade of purple yet. Anyway, if you've enjoyed this video, leave me a thumbs up. If you want to subscribe, click the subscribe button that's down there. There might actually be one on the screen somewhere too, where my end play thingy goes. And a couple of other videos that you might be interested in looking at, you know, if you wanna. And click the little bell if you wanna get notified of when I upload new content. And and leave me a comment down below. I will at least like your comment, and if you ask me a question, I will attempt to answer it. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya.